Hey guys, what's up? Thank you for coming back to my YouTube channel for an all new video. My name is Eric Merced, and this is a new episode of Making Comics Diary. So this episode's not going to be that long. I thought I'd make up for the longer episode that I did, previous episode that I did. This was an episode that I was debating on whether I should just do a straight up tutorial video or if I should incorporate it into the Making Comics Diary series. Since it has to do with making comics, I just pretty much decided to make it part of a Making Comics Diary series or episode. So let's get right to it. As you all know who have been following this series, I am creating my comic in Procreate. I am using Clip Studio Paint to do a couple of things to get the comic ready after it's done for Webtoons, as I showed in the last video, and I am also using Affinity Photo. But all of the drawing, 100% of the drawing is happening in Procreate, so the thumbnailing, the penciling of the pages, the sketching, the inking, everything is happening in Procreate. So the basis of this video today is kind of like a mini tutorial on how to split panels in Procreate. Now, in Clip Studio, this is really easy to do. You can split panels in Clip Studio Paint in equal sizes. You can take one panel and split it to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, as many panels as you want in equal sizes. This is really simple to do in Clip Studio Paint. If you guys don't know how to do that in Clip Studio Paint, leave a comment in the comment section, and what I'll do is in the next Making Comics Diary episode, I will talk about how to do that in Clip Studio Paint. But when it comes to doing it in Procreate, you don't have any ability to do that other than doing it old school. This will probably be familiar territory for some of you guys, but for some of you guys, you may not know about this method on how to split panels equally in the old way, traditionally. So this video is going to be about how to do that. So maybe if you already know how to do this, you probably might want to skip the video. But if you don't know how to do this, we're going to get into it. So as you can see, I have a panel already drawn in Procreate. And like I said in the last video, one of the things that I do is I turn drawing assist on, and that helps me draw horizontal and vertical lines straight without having to use the quick line tool. So that's how I draw the basic panels. Now the thing is, what would happen if I wanted to take this panel and split it up into two panels evenly without having one panel be bigger than the other? I want both of these panels to be of equal size. So there's a trick that you can do to pretty much get that done very easily in Procreate, or even if you're working traditionally. Now let's take this panel for example. The first thing you have to do is just determine where the middle of this panel is, or this square is. Where is the middle? So how do you determine that? Very easily. I'm going to draw an X in this panel, and basically it's going to be one line stretching from one end of the panel to the other end of the panel. And I'm going to use quick line to make sure that my line gets straightened, and I'm going to use edit shape to make sure that that line is going from corner to corner, like so. So that's one line from one end of the box or the panel to the other end, and I'm going to do the same exact thing on the opposite side. And again, I'm going to hold it for quick line, and I'm going to use edit shape to make sure that my line is right on the corners where it's supposed to be. Now once I do that, I'm going to have a huge X on my panel, and basically the center of that X is where the center of the panel is. Let me try to get that as close to the center as I can. There we go. So now I've just determined where the center of my panel is. So let me lower the opacity to this. Let me create a new layer. Let me turn drawing assist on. And now I have just pretty much been able to split my panel in two. It's really simple. That is as simple as it can get. Draw an X from one corner of the panel to the other corner and do the same thing on the opposite side. And wherever those two lines meet to form the X, that is the center of your panel. You can do this to determine the center of a square, the center of a rectangle. You can also use this method to determine the center of those, not just the panel. Okay, so that's splitting it into two. What if I wanted to split this up into, say, three panels of equal sizes? All right, let me show you how to do that. All right, so splitting up the panel into three panels, we're gonna use the same formula that we use to determine where the center of the panel is. We're gonna do an X, and then after we do an X from one corner to the other corner of the panel, we're gonna determine where the center is, where those two lines meet. And now the next step is pretty simple. We're gonna use that center line as our main point to divide the panel again so that we can split it up into three. So from the top of that, or the bottom if you want, but from the top of that center line, we're gonna draw a line from there to one corner of the panel, like so. Again, we're gonna use quick line, and we're going to use edit shape to make sure that our lines are properly butted against the end of each corner, right? So we're gonna do that again, just like that. We're gonna do that again, just like this. Use edit shape to make sure that everything is nicely lined up. All right, so now basically where these lines meet right here, where I'm circling, that's where you're going to draw your straight line. So let's do that. Let's turn drawing assist on. And now we've successfully basically split our panel into three. So we have one panel here, a second panel here, and a third panel here. So basically, if we ignore all these other lines, we've successfully split up our panel into three equal size sections. Now, what happens if we want to, and this is gonna be the limit that we're gonna go up to, but we can do this as many times as we want, but what happens if we wanna go up to four panels? Well, let me show you how to do that. All right, so now that we've determined these new lines here with these new, where these new X's meet, denoted by the blue lines right here, right? We're going to again do the same thing we did to split the panel into three. We're going to do the same exact thing with these new lines. We're going to use them as our anchor point. So we're going to draw from the top of this line to the very corner of the panel. We're going to do another line, use quick shape, and use edit shape to make sure that your line is reaching the corners the way you want them to, like so. And now where these new lines meet, this is where you're going to draw your lines to split the panel. So let's turn drawing assist on and draw our lines. Now this all seems like a mess. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to turn the opacity down on these lines, these guidelines. I'm gonna go to a new layer. I'm gonna just choose red just so you guys can see clearly. And I'm going to draw my lines where they split. So one line there, and another line there. And I have one, two, three, four panels of equal size. Now keep in mind, this is not this method doesn't also work vertically, it also works horizontally. So if you want to do if you want to find the center of the panel, horizontally speaking, you can do that. And you can split panels like that too. So it works either way, but this helps you basically find the center of your box or panel or frame or whatever you want to call it, and it helps you split them up into as many equal parts as you want. Again, this is easily done in Clip Studio Paint, but in Procreate, unfortunately, we don't have a way to do this. So this is a traditional method used when you're drawing traditionally to equally divide your panels using these guidelines. Okay, so the other trick that I want to show you is how to create an equal size gutter. So for you guys that don't know what a gutter is, I'm going to show you what a gutter is. So the gutter is basically when we do our panels, we don't do them, you know, like one panel butted up against the other. You can do that for stylistic reasons. But generally, when you're drawing panels, you usually have a gutter. And the gutter is this area right here, which is basically the area that separates one panel from the other, right? When one scene is transitioning to another scene, there is a separation. That's called the gutter of the page. So there is a trick that I use in Procreate to keep the gutter size the same throughout all of my pages, okay? Again, in Clip Studio Paint, this is easy because all you have to do is go into preferences and change a specific setting and set how wide you want the gutter to be, vertically and horizontally, and you set it and forget it. You don't have to worry about it ever again if you're using that same Clip Studio Paint file. But unfortunately, in Procreate, it's not set up for that because it's not really set up for comic book making in mind. So you have to find ways to work around these kinds of limitations. So this method that I use is pretty much the method that you can use to determine a gutter size that you can use for all of your panels. So what I'm gonna do is I just created a new layer. This layer with all the guides, I'm gonna lower the opacity and I'm gonna go ahead and create a new layer and I'm gonna turn drawing assist on, all right? And then I'm gonna draw one single line down. And now I'm gonna determine how wide I want my gutter to be by drawing another line next to that. So let's make that a little smaller. All right, there you go. So that's gonna be my gutter size, all right? So what I would do next is I would, let me turn drawing assist off. I would duplicate this layer, right? And maybe just for a visual cue, I'll change the color of it to something like blue. So let's fill that right there. All right. And let's move that from its position. So we can see we have a blue version and a red version. One's gonna be my horizontal gutter and one is gonna be my vertical gutter. So if you want, you can even rename these. So HG for horizontal gutter, and rename this for VG for vertical gutter. So let's take our horizontal gutter and let's take the transform tool and let's flip it or rotate it by 45 degrees like so, all right? And that automatically becomes our vertical gutter. So now we have, our horizontal gutter. So now we have a horizontal gutter and we have a vertical gutter. What I would do now is suggest that you would copy or duplicate these. So keep these as your main guide layers, right? So for example, I'll just turn this off. So I need a vertical gutter, right? So I'll just go ahead and duplicate this. And let me just bring it up here and turn the visibility on and drag it to the spot where I need it. Now I need another one because I have four panels, right? So let me duplicate that and drag that to the center there. Actually, let me fix this here and drag it more to the center. There we go. And duplicate that and do the same thing. And now I can just kind of merge these and use the eraser tool to erase anything that I don't need, or even use the selection tool to just get rid of the excess that I don't need. Let's do clear there. And let me turn this guides off, and there you go. Let me turn these guides off. And there you go. You've basically created a gutter of the same size that you can use either horizontally or vertically in your comic, and that way you'll create consistency in all of your pages. The last thing you want is one gutter to be bigger than the other or smaller than the other, unless That's what you're going for, stylistically speaking. But if that's not what you're going to, and you want to create some kind of consistency throughout all of your pages, throughout your entire comic, this is a trick that you can use. Create your vertical and horizontal gutters separately, and then you can duplicate those to use them in the page, in the pages as you want. So here's the result of the four panels split up in equal size with the gutter on each panel of equal size. I hope you guys enjoyed these little tips and tricks that you can use in Procreate to create your comics. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next episode. God bless and peace.